Do you know what makes a mammal different from a reptile? Or why amphibians live in two worlds, water and land? Imagine frogs leaping, eagles soaring, and reptiles basking in the sun. Watch as animals take the stage to share their incredible secrets in the wild. Ready to dive in? Once upon a time in the lively land of Creatureville, animals from all corners of the world gathered for the much-anticipated annual animal classification picnic. This year, the competition was fierce. Each animal group had to show off their best traits to prove why they were unique and deserving of the grand prize, a lifetime supply of their favorite treats. The judges? A lively crowd of third graders, ready to cheer, laugh, and learn. The day was sunny, and the excitement was palpable. Creatures big and small, furry and scaly, winged and webbed, were all eager to take the stage and show off their features, habitats, foods, and quirky characteristics. The first to take the stage was Max the Mammal, a regal lion with a golden mane that swayed with the wind. He strutted confidently, his large paws leaving prints in the grass. "Roar! Hello, friends!" Max began, his voice booming. "I'm Max, and I'm here to represent the mammals. We're warm-blooded creatures, which means we keep our bodies cozy and warm, no matter the weather. And look at this fur!" Max shook his mane proudly. "It helps keep me warm in the cold and protected in the wild." Max wasn't alone. Beside him stood Lola the lemur, a tiny but agile mammal with big, curious eyes. "Us mammals come in all shapes and sizes. I may be small, but I've got fur too, and I live in the rainforests, leaping from tree to tree in search of fruit." Betty the bat swooped down from the trees, flapping her leathery wings. "Don't forget, not all mammals are covered in thick fur. I'm a bat, and I'm a mammal too. I might fly like a bird, but I nurse my babies with milk, just like Max and Lola."
Max grinned and continued. "We mammals live all over the world, in jungles, deserts, and even your homes. And when it comes to food, well, it varies. I love a good steak, but some mammals, like Gus the gorilla over there, prefer fruits and leaves."
Gus waved from the crowd, munching on a banana.
"Fruits are the best,"
he called out, making the audience laugh.
"And let's not forget," Max added, "we mammals are famous for taking care of our babies. Whether we're lions, lemurs, or bats, we all make sure our little ones get plenty of milk when they're born."
Next, swimming gracefully across the stage in a large fish tank was Finley the fish, a shimmering clownfish with bright orange and white stripes.
"Bloop! Bloop! Hi, everyone! I'm Finley, and I represent the fish group. We fish are cold-blooded, which means we rely on the water around us to stay warm or cool."
Finley's scales sparkled in the sunlight. "Unlike Max and his furry friends, we fish are covered in scales that protect us and help us swim smoothly through the water." Beside Finley, Sammy the salmon splashed playfully.
"We fish live in water, oceans, rivers, lakes, you name it. Some of us even swim from the ocean to the rivers, like me, Sammy the salmon. It's quite the journey."
Goldie the goldfish popped up next, her golden scales shining brightly.
"Our homes can be big, like the ocean, or small, like a cozy fish tank in your living room. But no matter where we live, we all breathe underwater using gills, which is way cooler than lungs, if you ask me."
Finley nodded. "And as for food, we love plants, algae, and sometimes smaller fish. But don't worry, Goldie and I stick to plants." Goldie wiggled her tail.
"That's right! Seaweed salads for me!"
Suddenly, a flurry of feathers filled the sky as Benny the bird, a vibrant red parrot, swooped onto the stage.
"Caw, caw! Greetings, everyone! We birds are proud to be warm-blooded, just like mammals, but our bodies are covered in feathers, not fur."
Benny fluffed up his rainbow-colored feathers, making sure everyone could see.
Feathers help us fly, stay warm, and even show off to our friends.
Oh, and don't forget, we birds lay eggs, big ones, small ones, colorful ones. It's an egg-cellent way to start life.
Flying beside Benny was Olivia the owl, her wide eyes gleaming as she hooted softly. Us birds live everywhere, from forests to deserts to mountains. Some of us, like me, love hunting at night, and others, like Daisy the duck, enjoy swimming in ponds all day.
Daisy gave a cheerful quack. That's right! We birds can live on land, in trees, or even on water, and we eat all sorts of things. Seeds, fruits, insects, and sometimes fish. I'm all about the water plants, though.
Benny added, and of course our wings help us fly. Well, except for some of our friends like Penny the penguin over there, but she's a great swimmer.
Next up was Rita the reptile, a sleek green iguana with shiny scales. She crawled slowly onto the stage, flicking her tongue.
Sheesh. Hello, friends. I'm Rita, here to represent the reptiles. We're cold-blooded, which means we love soaking up the sun to stay warm.
Rita showed off her scales. We reptiles are covered in tough, dry scales that protect us and help us blend into our surroundings.
Carter the crocodile joined her, his jaws snapping playfully.
We reptiles love warm places, deserts, swamps, and jungles. I live in rivers and lakes, but some of my friends, like Tina the tortoise, prefer dry, hot deserts.
Tina slowly made her way onto the stage, her shell gleaming.
That's right. We reptiles have shells, scales, and sometimes even venom, and we eat all kinds of things, plants, insects, and even small animals.
Rita flicked her tongue again.
Don't forget, we lay eggs too, just like birds, but ours are often hidden in warm sand or dirt.
Hopping along came Axel the amphibian, a bright green frog. He leaped onto the stage with a big grin.
Ribbit, ribbit! Hey there! I'm Axel, and I'm part of the amphibians. We're pretty special because we can live in water when we're young and on land when we're grown up.
Axel waved to Sally the salamander, who slithered up beside him. Us amphibians have smooth, moist skin that helps us breathe, especially when we're in water. And when we're not hopping around ponds, we're chilling on land, munching on insects.
Sally nodded.
That's right. We're known for our ability to live in both worlds, water and land. Plus, we start life as eggs in water, then grow into tadpoles or larvae, and finally into our adult forms.
Frankie the frog hops into view, his vibrant green skin glistening in the sunlight, speckled with tiny darker spots that help him blend into the surrounding leaves. His big, bulging eyes are full of mischief and excitement as he demonstrates his amazing tongue skills. With a quick flick, his long, sticky tongue darts out, snatching at an imaginary fly hovering just in front of him. The movement is so swift that you can almost see the blur of his tongue in action.
Surrounding Frankie are a few other frogs, all chuckling at his antics. One frog, Lola, with bright yellow markings, is sitting on a lily pad, trying to suppress her laughter. Another, Benny, a darker green frog, is watching intently, eyes wide with admiration. Nearby, a few insects flit around, providing a tempting feast for the frogs, with a couple of dragonflies buzzing lazily above the pond. The pond is alive with activity, with dragonflies zipping around and beetles skimming the water's surface. Tall grass and colorful wildflowers frame the pond, adding bursts of color to the green landscape. The trees surrounding the pond are dense with leaves, creating a cozy, shaded area perfect for the frogs. The sounds of nature fill the air, the gentle croaking of frogs, the buzzing of insects,
and the soft rustling of leaves, all blending into a harmonious symphony. Finally, buzzing her way onto the stage was Ivy the insect, a cheerful bumblebee.
Buzz, buzz, hello! We insects may be small, but we're super important. We have three body parts: head, thorax, and abdomen, and six legs.
Beside her, Charlie the caterpillar wiggled onto the stage. And some of us, like me, will grow into something totally different, like a butterfly. Betty the beetle waved her antennae.
We insects live everywhere, in gardens, forests, even inside your homes sometimes. And we eat all sorts of things, plants, nectar, leaves, and other insects.
Ivy buzzed proudly.
And we're also really helpful to plants, spreading pollen and making sure they grow big and strong.
As the animals finished their presentations, the third graders erupted into cheers and applause, their excitement echoing across the sunny meadow. The annual animal classification picnic had turned out to be a huge success, filled with laughter, learning, and unforgettable moments. Each group of animals had showcased their unique traits, from Max the Mammal's furry friends to Ivy the insect's buzzing charm, leaving the children in awe of the diverse world of wildlife around them. The students had not only learned about the characteristics that distinguish mammals, fish, birds, reptiles, amphibians, and insects, but they had also discovered the vital roles each group plays in the ecosystem. They listened intently as the animals shared fascinating facts, and many were inspired to ask questions, showing their eagerness to understand more about the animal kingdom. As the sun began to set, casting a golden hue over the picnic area, the children gathered around to share their favorite moments, swapping stories and giggles. Food filled the air with delightful scents, sandwiches, fruit salads, and sweet treats, providing the perfect fuel for their enthusiastic discussions. Some kids even took turns trying to imitate their favorite animals, hopping like frogs or waddling like penguins, which sent everyone into fits of laughter. Teachers and parents exchanged proud glances, knowing that this day had sparked a newfound appreciation for nature in the hearts of their students. As the picnic drew to a close, the children began to pack up their belongings, but not without promising to share what they had learned with their families. They left with full bellies, new knowledge, and huge smiles on their faces, cherishing the friendships they had formed and the unforgettable memories they had created together. The day had not just been an educational experience, it had become a celebration of curiosity, wonder, and the joy of learning about the incredible world of animals.